All right, today we're going to be talking about a few different topics. You guys enjoyed the last video I did like this, and I think it helps me so that I don't have to bombard you guys with several videos, although you can expect at least 3 to 5 videos from me a week. But we're going to be hitting some really weird mixes of drama today, some combinations of things that I don't think anybody expected, and a few updates too. So let's just hop into it.
If I was to tell you that Five Nights at Freddy's and Nicolas Cage have more in common than you think. Well, you may be surprised to even hear Nicolas Cage mentioned alongside Five Nights at Freddy's, let alone that they have anything in common. But to tell you the truth, they have more in common than you guys would imagine. Nicolas Cage is a huge iconic figure, sort of a meme around the internet and entertainment community. And Five Nights at Freddy's is, you know, a well-known game. It has transformed and transcended into meme culture as well here and there. So to see that they, you know, are finally coming together in this realistic marriage makes sense to me. I mean, Nicolas Cage has been in every single Five Nights at Freddy's video game. You probably just haven't seen him or spotted him. I mean, he's pretty relevant in most of them. I think a couple people have screenshots here from Twitter, but There is a pretty big Twitter outrage right now over this movie that Nicolas Cage will be starring in. And I think most people have a problem. The people that have a problem with it, their problem is that there is a FNAF movie, a Five Nights at Freddy's movie, coming out. And this movie sort of rips off what Five Nights at Freddy's is. What is Five Nights at Freddy's, you might be asking? Well, Jesus Christ, man, have you been living under a rock for the last decade? So, Five Nights at Freddy's is a horror game where animatronics in a restaurant, much like Chuck E. Cheese, come to life at night and terrorize whoever the security guard is. Typically, that's you who's playing the game. And this movie, Willy's Wonderland, basically embodies that same storyline. Nicolas Cage is sort of the security guard janitor type figure who's taking, you know, on this job, and these animatronics come to life, and some people have already been like, yo, Nicolas Cage is just saying like, hey, if I was in the Five Nights at Freddy's universe, I would have been clapping some cheeks. I would have been slapping some animatronics, and I would have been handling it. Let's just see what people have to say about this, and just kind of like this instant outrage that's going on kind of right now. So, on one hand, I'm thinking that it looks like a fun, cheesy movie, but on the other hand, it just feels petty to make a Five Nights at Freddy's ripoff before the actual creator of FNAF hasn't even finished his movie yet. I don't know, man. It just feels wrong. Bruh, now when the Five Nights at Freddy's movie comes out, people will think it's a knockoff of this. Why not just call this FNAF? Or are we just skipping out on paying Scott? So, just so other people know, the FNAF movie is still in development. The reason for it taking forever is just simple. Scott wanting to be very specific over some things, and for going through several scripts. However, now they have settled on one, and the movie is starting filming in the spring. I'm assuming all the script rejecting was due to Hollywood wanting to do stupid stuff with it like Hollywood does, and if Scott's rejected script thread had anything to say about it, that was the case. All these other animatronic movies seem to be going to the comedy side anyways, So that's why the Five Nights at Freddy's movie took so long. They completely changed the plot and hired Nicolas Cage. I was sort of interested to find out what any FNAF fans actually think about this, whether they are actually pissed off and kind of just worried about what the FNAF movie will be like after, you know, multiple of these movies come out, the same kind of horror animatronics kind of theme. I think fans of FNAF are worried that it's going to taint, you know, Five Nights at Freddy's, the movie, when it does release.
I can understand that. I mean, I feel like Five Nights at Freddy's has held its own throughout the years. Fans are extremely dedicated. I personally don't think that, you know, this stuff is really going to taint Five Nights at Freddy's when it comes out. People that don't know it, of course, are probably going to associate it with these other movies instantly, but that's just because they don't know it. But once they, you know, if they fall in love with it, they want to find out more. There is a plethora of knowledge to inform people that, you know, Scott has been working on this type of stuff for years. And that's just kind of the main argument I'm seeing out there, is that people are pretty pissed off about this kind of being a ripoff. And it seems like other people that just don't know about it are just, you know, hyped for a Nicolas Cage movie. So I think this is kind of a weird and interesting connection between two completely different worlds that I've partaken in for years. I've watched, you know, other Nicolas Cage movies, and I've played the majority of Five Nights at Freddy's games when I used to do Let's Plays on my channel. So it might feel rare for me to talk about Five Nights at Freddy's, but I have wanted to bring it up in the past, and it feels funny to do it now in association with such an iconic character as Nicolas Cage. All right, next we got a Minecraft story, which is the reason why we're playing some TNT Run today. It looks like Dream is trending on Twitter again, and I first of all, I gotta just, you know, think to myself, what could this possibly be? He was just recently doxxed. We know his stans are out of control. We know that there was some issues with an ex-girlfriend. There was a lot of threats, like, even on his life. He's been dealing with the whole cheating scandal and trying to prove his side, even though his astrophysicist or whatever from Yale University down at UCLA, you know, said that, you know, he cheated. The guy that he hired even said he cheated. So I'm just wondering what the hell could Dream be in, like, what could be going on with this man right now? And then I click on the thing to find out, and it says, fans of Minecraft content creator Dream congratulate him for reaching 16 million subscribers. That feels like a weird structured sentence anyways. But so Dream hit 16 million subscribers. That's huge, man. That's honestly gigantic. And here I am, and YouTube's like, no, you will never reach 100K. And I'm like, oh, fuck. But Dream, congrats. Congrats to this guy. It looks like, you know, it's just so weird to think that there was so much going on with this guy, so much controversy just recently. Tons of people making videos about him. Whether, you know, it's ups and downs, a roller coaster ride of whether people are defending him or not, you know, when it comes to the whole cheating thing, just because he also went through so many things with the docs and his ex-girlfriend. Man's been on an actual roller coaster of a life ride right now, and then he's hit 16 million subscribers, which just goes to prove that, like, his content is entertaining to the audience that he's giving it to. He knows his audience, and he knows what content to deliver, so it doesn't matter what this guy does in his outside life, it seems like. It's just, you know, all about the content. And, it's not for me. I'm not a kid that's watching Minecraft. If you guys have seen some of my tweets and stuff, you know I watch Forsen, who plays Minecraft. But I'm not in on the whole YouTube Minecraft scene. I'm more on Twitch. But, you know, congrats to this dude. It's interesting. I know there's going to be fans that are just going to be like, yeah, hell yeah, congrats to him. And I know there's going to be people that are just truly angry about it and think that he's just getting away with stuff. So I'm interested to deliver this information and see what people think. But congrats to Dream, man. 16 million subs. If I could only hit 100K, that maybe YouTube would treat me better. I've been expecting Yandere Dev to make his progress report that he always does on the 1st and the 15th of the month. And here we are. He has an update to the game finally. It's been quite a while since we've seen anything from Yandere Dev. I think the last time we saw something was around Christmas of last year, and it is now in the middle of January 2021. So what can we expect from Yandere Dev? As always, I think we can expect him to, you know, be pushing out ideas that people may not really want and is probably reluctant to do so. If you can see some of these leaks from his Discord server, there is this conversation he's having with somebody about whether he wants to, you know, make an announcement video about the new update or, you know, talk about a new Easter egg. Just check out what he has to say here. I have a feeling that if I created any type of content that isn't direct progress on Yandere Simulator, people would get angry with me. Think about the shithead dumbass who were here a moment ago who was advocating for me deleting all Easter eggs from the game. Some dumb fucks are so stupid they get upset if I spend 30 minutes putting a cute Easter egg into the game. If I took the time to make gaming content and upload it to YouTube, that type of person would get furious and just harass me more than they already do. I think what Yandere Dev is missing here is not really, like, I don't think people are upset about, you know, what he does with his time. I've seen him waste plenty of time here and there throughout the years watching, you know, the development of this game. But it's how he handles people's responses to this. Like, just the way he talks in this Discord server to, you know, fans and community members alike, it's just not very cool. It's not a good look. It's pretty shitty of an attitude to have. And I mean, he's been through this for years, so I don't think he's ever gonna change. This is just kind of the constant theme for Yandere Dev. And you can see this other leak from his Discord server where, you know, he's implementing a new change and he just does it. He does it poorly and he puts the wrong voice lines for the wrong character. And it's just an example of, like, you know, his game developing skills. It's been years of development and this kind of stuff still happens. I think this is more of a, you know, humorous note. You know, he added these voice lines that are dark. You know, here, I'll read exactly what he says. Today, I'm giving the student council voice lines. While implementing their lines, I accidentally gave Akane Ayo's lines. I butchered that. I know I did. And now she says violent, threatening things. So, Yandere Dev is doing his best to implement new updates to the game. I believe there is, you know, a new Easter egg I saw. It kind of featured, it seems like, in that Discord leak. He's also celebrating his anniversary of streaming, which is, you know what, dude, get a round of applause, everybody. Let's give him a round of applause. Hell yeah. That's quite the accomplishment to be a chair boy sitting in a chair streaming to people. It's the amazing accomplishment, better than making a game. So let's check out to see what he says that he's been doing. In December, I uploaded seven videos in a row. It took me a long time, about a month, to prepare all those videos. During that period of time, a lot of people reported bugs and suggested some really clever ways to improve the game. But I chose to postpone all bug fixes and improvements because I want to focus exclusively on completing the videos. As a result, a lot of bug reports and great suggestions piled up into one really big list. Over the past few weeks, I've been going through that list, fixing all of the bugs that were reported, and making numerous quality of life improvements to the game. I'm also finished with that list. Only a small handful of things remain, and I only need a few more days to finish going through it. Latest progress? In my December 20th video, I mentioned that almost no players bother to dispose of corpses, which should be a priority in a game about getting away with murder. As a solution, I proposed the idea of giving the players numerous harsh penalties for failing to dispose of corpses. However, people in the comments section suggested a better idea: determine why people don't enjoy disposing of corpses and then make it more fun and interesting to dispose of corpses. This is actually, like, if this came from the community, you know what, dude? Okay, so it is sad to say, it's not sad because it's actually kind of like, let me say it this way. It's amazing that the community can, you know, come up with better ideas, greater solutions to a game that a developer has been making for years. It's sad that the developer can't think of these ideas without the community's help getting there. These would be things that you would, you know, restart from the very beginning. You would be trying to figure out why, you know, these elements of the game aren't fun, why people aren't doing them. You wouldn't imagine people aren't doing them just because they're not doing them. You would imagine people aren't doing these things in the game because they're not fun to do. So I'm excited to see how this will play out. Let's continue reading. Honestly, that should have occurred to me immediately. So he says it right. He says it right there. I didn't even read this part. He says it right there. Please, man, come on, just do your job. Yandere Dev, do your job and think of this stuff beforehand. So in between bug fixes and general improvements, I've been implementing some new features that should make it way more fun and convenient to clean up after committing murder. I'll give you a preview of a few of them. And he shows some pictures. There's a washing machine. It looks like there's trash bags. And it looks like there is the overcoat and boots that I've seen before. It's been a long time since I've seen this. It's been so long since I've actually done the debug mode and played around with any of the Easter eggs in this build. I think I'll actually check that out. So this isn't everything that will appear in the next update, but it should help you get an idea of what types of things I'm currently working on. Is that all? Nope, there's more. So far, the next build contains 43 differences from the previous build. Oh! Some of the ones that I think will be interesting to you are a few adjustments have been made to elimination methods to make them go by faster. This will be particularly interesting to speedrunners, which I would love to give another go at. The Senpai and Amai cutscene will also have actual animations instead of static poses. There is an additional bounty besides Ryuto's bounty. And the student council girls will have voice lines, and there will be one new Easter egg added. Also, I've done a bit of outside work of the game as well. I've also updated the character pages with some text for characters that previously had no text. This is on his main website. So, and then he goes on to talk about his 12 years of streaming. So that is the update directly from the WordPress and some leaks that I found that were on the Osana subreddit. Honestly, if you check out the subreddit, you can kind of like tell what's going to be happening in the updates, you know, a few days prior to them coming out. I had been checking out the subreddit on the 14th, and you know, I was already kind of thinking about making the video, and then I saw that Yandere Dev had actually posted his update on the 15th. I think I'm going to take my time to check out the update now and see what the gameplay is like. I hope you guys enjoyed this little update video, and I think I'll, you know, directly say something to anybody that's like, hey, yo, man, I know you're milking Yandere Dev. There was this really funny comment. I didn't pin it, and I was telling my girlfriend about it, and I didn't pin it, or like, you know, take a clip of it or anything, or save it, but it was a super funny comment that was from this really angry Yandere Dev fan, and he was like, or she, I don't know, but they were like, you milking this dev? I hope that even a piece of bread one day is a meal for you. And I was just like, what? I was all, dang. What actual hate behind this comment? I mean, you know, I'm not going to praise anybody for giving me hate comments. So don't go out of your way to make them. I'm not going to mention them all the time. But I just thought that one was particularly funny just because of the extreme actual rage that I could feel behind the words. So for an answer to anybody that's like, are you milking this? Listen, this guy's making a game. He does updates that I follow and I make videos about. When he stops updating his game and making progress reports, that's when I will stop following it. Some people have asked, you know, are you like a Cub Scouts or Bijou Mike, like when they've seen my Let's Plays or streams? And the answer is, like, not really. We're more of, like, a commentary channel that, you know, does gameplay here and there and streams gameplay. So, you know, if you like YouTube commentary about other topics other than Yandere Simulator, then, you know, stick around. If you like Yandere Simulator gameplay and me checking out the updates, then stick around. You'll probably enjoy the content no matter what. But I thought I'd just directly answer that since I know it's a meme as well, you know, people will say what they say, but I thought I'd directly answer the milking thing because I know just some people probably don't know that I'm just following this guy's updates. So a little rant there at the end, a little explanation. That's going to do it for today's video, guys. I mixed together some audio recordings that I had done separately. I think I'm going to start doing videos where I put more topics together. It seems like some of you guys enjoyed that, and I'm enjoying it as well. So, I mean, we'll see where that goes. You guys can always tell on my channel if you've been following it for a while that we go through different arcs, and I try new stuff. So, hopefully, it hits, and you guys enjoy these new types of videos. Otherwise, yeah, I'll see you guys next time. Everybody take care out there. Later.